Welcome to Getting Started with Graphics on your Daktronics control system. This tutorial will give a brief summary of all the components that make up your system and demonstrates how to create a graphic in Content Studio and play it on your display. Follow along on screen or with your own Daktronics equipment as we explore the components and features of your system. The system consists of three control components. The first is a DMP8000 computer. DMP stands for Digital Media Player and is where all the graphic content for the display is stored. The second component is a VIP, or Video Image Processor. The model of VIP may vary, but its purpose is to convert the signal from the DMP8000 computer into a fiber optic signal for the display to use. The final component is a Show Control Computer. Used to control the DMP8000 and to create graphic content, the show control is connected through a router. The show control computer may be an all-in-one touchscreen PC or a laptop. Before we begin, ensure that power is turned on to the display. Turn on the video image processor and wait 3 minutes for it to start up. Next, turn on the DMP8000 computer, followed by the show control computer. Now let's create a piece of graphic content for the display. Open Display Studio by double-clicking the desktop icon. Display Studio is the interface program used to create buttons that control the display. Your system should come pre-configured with content and buttons organized in various tabs along the top. Any tab or button can be deleted if that item is not needed. To delete an unneeded item, right-click and choose Delete. To create your own graphic, click on the pencil icon in the upper right corner to open Content Studio. Content Studio is a content compositor in which you can overlay real-time data, import pictures and videos, and add text to make creative visual presentations for your display. To create a new presentation, click the File menu in the top left corner and choose New. If a prompt appears with Display and Display Type, choose Display. Then choose the zone in which the content will be designed for. A black box will open near the middle of the screen. This represents the display window. To change the background color, click on the Format tab, choose a pre-configured color, or enter a specific RGB color value by clicking the down arrow to the right of the color selections. After the background color has been selected, text can be added to the presentation by going to the Home tab and selecting Text Box. Click anywhere in the display to create a text box. Type the message and click outside the text box when finished. Text options, including font size and style, can be found under the Home tab. To save, click the Save icon in the top left corner, or click File and Save. A file browser will appear and should be showing the content folder on the DMP8000 computer. This is the specific location where all content is stored for the display. It's best practice to create subfolders in the content folder to help keep your files organized. To create a new folder, click on the folder icon with a star in the file browser window. Name the file appropriately and click Save. When the file is done saving, return to Display Studio. A button sends a command to the DMP8000 computer, which then plays the content to the display. To make a button, right-click in the gray area and select New Button. Click on the plus sign in the bottom of the box. Choose DMP8000 Player Control and click Step 2. Step 2 selects the zone in which the content will play. The number of zones in a system may vary. Choose the zone in which the content was designed for. Step 3 should be left on play. In Step 4, click the Add button and browse to the location where the file is stored and select it. Click Open to add it to the button. In Step 5, leave it set to Continuous. Name the button so you can identify it later by highlighting the word Play and entering a new name. Click Save to complete the button. If the properties of a button need to be changed after saving it, right-click on the button and click Properties to reopen the button window. Finally, click the button to play the content to the display. This concludes the tutorial for getting started with graphics. Visit our YouTube channel, Daktronics Control Systems, to learn more about your Daktronics display and show control.